Finally, I want to point out one other aspect of JavaScript, and that's its memory management approach. JavaScript is garbage collected, which means for us developers, we don't need to worry about pointers, deleting objects, or how to handle local variables, any of that. We can just declare things like this and forget about them. The downside is that the JavaScript engine has to handle that itself. And when it decides to run the garbage collector, nothing else runs. This can trigger visible pauses in rendering the page. Like I said earlier, the JavaScript you write isn't the JavaScript that runs, thanks to JIT. So it's not always easy to predict whether your code is going to be garbagey. It also depends heavily on the frameworks and libraries you use and how you structure your code. That's why you need to measure first. Well, the good news is that Chrome's DevTools will show you memory usage in your projects. Okay, take a look at this. I made this a while ago. Don't ask me, it's pretty weird. I'm not quite sure what kind of mood I was in that day. Yeah. Anyway, what we can do is we can see the memory usage of this demo in Chrome DevTools. You can see up here, I've switched on the memory profiler, and I'm going to run it like so, and I'm going to stop. What we see is this sawtooth pattern here, and that's actually fine. We expect JavaScript to use some memory, and eventually, when this drop-off happens, that's the garbage collector running. There are two things we're looking for here. Firstly, are there a lot of fast climbs here? That can indicate that we're assigning a lot of memory very quickly and very often. Secondly, when the garbage collector runs, does it take it back to zero? If not, we might have a memory leak. If we're interested in a little more detail on the garbage collection, we can switch off the memory profiler here and then go to the search down here. If that's not on your screen, you can hit Command F or Control F. Enter GC into the field and then hit Enter. In my case, I've got 7 results and I can step through them with these arrows. And you can see, for example, I'm only spending a fraction of a millisecond here. If you find that you're missing frames because of garbage collection, then there are some fabulous resources you can use to learn more about patterns and practices that will help you avoid creating too much garbage. Check out the instructor notes if you want more information.